It's a desolate landscape of sun, wind, and salt. 1,400 acres of industrial salt ponds south of the city of Napa. Now owned by the California Department of Fish and Game, biologists are guiding the restoration of tidal marshes that existed there more than 100 years ago. As a first step in the restoration, low islands were created to provide nesting sites for the endangered California least tern. Biologist Karen Taylor studies the results of this effort that is intended to help rebuild least tern populations.
There's a half an acre island, which is this one. It's the, what we call the East Island. We placed oyster shells on it. The main island, which is not too far from us to the west, is an acre and a half, the largest island, and we used the substrate from the levees that the terns nested on last year. And then the third island is an acre, so it's in between the two, and we used rock and substrate. Now next year we're planning on putting, since the oyster shell island was so successful nesting and the most preferred, we're planning on placing oyster shells on the other two islands. Last year we had a total of 48 nests at Napa plant site, and that's with the first and the second wave of nesting. This year to date, right now we're at 45 nests, so we're on our way to exceeding that, which is great. So if you guys want to see a three egg nest, there's number 43's over here still incubating.
Karen counts the nests and monitors the progress of every egg.
So I've got a system of what I line up with before I go across, and then I just kind of keep going as best I can in a straight line, but I do have to veer a little because I try to avoid a lot of oyster shells. I try to go for the smooth spots to step on. It's a nerve-wracking thing to do these surveys. I try to find all the nests that I have to date, whether they're eggs in there anymore or not. 36, two eggs. So there's 24, and that was a dead chick next to that one. Number 25 still has an egg. 22 hatched last time. What they do normally is the adults are courting and mating somewhere nearby. They don't want to have the activity of that near where they're going to be laying their eggs. Because it decreases the amount of time of attracting predators. So they do all their business somewhere else, come here, and then nest. And then as soon as they nest, what they've been doing and what I noticed in the past last year is they're getting off the island or getting off where their nest is, away from the nest. And I think it's just a strategy. They've got the successful chicks. They're precocial. They move pretty much quick right away. And it's just kind of a surviving mechanism.
Totaling more than 10,000 acres, the Napa Salt Pond Project is one of the largest wetland restoration efforts in the nation.